Okay, I'm going to show you different techniques of how to get different textures in your cityscape buildings. So on your paper, you are going to label the different watercolor techniques that I have posted up on the board. It doesn't matter where you place them or what order you place them in, just know that I will be looking to see each one of the techniques demonstrated. Okay, so let's get started first with your flat wash. This is where you're going to have just a flat colored background. So you want to get your brush wet, and then you'll pick whatever color you want. So for this one, I'm going to use orange. Dip it in the orange. And you're going to want quite a bit of paint on there. Not so much water, but quite a bit of paint on there. Okay? And then you're going to make a stroke, and that is going to be consistent with the same amount of paint all the way through. And so my paper is wet now from this because it's not watercolor paper, so it soaks it up pretty fast and it makes it look like the color is wrong, and it's not. So you can just correct that by putting layering more paint over that. But it's just a flat wash. It's the same consistency of color all the way through. There's not really any value on it. So then in order to create a gradient wash, you can select a different color if you'd like. I'm going to choose red. You start with a lot of one color, and as you go down, you just add more water to it. And not any paint. And it will create a gradient effect from dark to light. So I'm going to clean my brush again, and now I want you to try the technique called wet on wet. So the first thing that I have to do is I clean my brush out with water, I get my paper wet, and it's going to soak it up because, this, like I said, this isn't watercolor paper, so it's going to soak it up. So you don't want to get it super soaked so you end up putting a hole in it, but then after it's wet, you wet your brush again and pick another color. So for this one, I'm going to choose this. And you're going to get quite a bit of water and paint on there as well, and you can paint over the top of the fact that it's wet, and you can see how the paint moves differently because the paper was already wet to begin with. Okay, the next one I want you to do is dry brush. So for this one, you're going to have a dry brush. Let me grab my paper towel. I grab the paper towel, clean out my brush, make sure it's pretty dry. Okay, the next thing you're going to want to do is find a different color then to use. So the paintbrush is dry, but not completely, and you can swirl it around in your paint. You notice that you're able to see then those brush strokes because you're working with dry paper and a fairly dry brush. Okay, it creates almost a scratching effect. Okay, another one I'm going to show you is blotting. So you're going to get your paintbrush wet. You're going to pick your color that you want to use. Use purple for this one. And you want to do this quickly, but you're going to lift some of that paint off the paper. So the paper that we're using is not watercolor paper. I know I keep saying this. So it soaks up pretty fast, so you have to be quick with this technique. And it will lift it up into splotches. That can be a cool effect for clouds. Okay. Another one is splattering. And I'm sure some of you are aware of this one. The first thing you want to do is get a color down already. So I'm going to go to my yellow. And it looks like it has some green into it. So be careful with your colors. Make sure you're cleaning your brush after every one. So I have my yellow down. I'm going to pull a little bit more because it's a very light color. The less water you use, the more intense your color will be as well. Okay, so I'm going to clean my brush. I'm going to go back in with a red. And you want less water and more paint for this technique. And then you can tap your paintbrush and it will create this splattering effect into that color. Okay, you have to be very careful. I don't want you jamming it onto the paper because then you'll get it into all your other buildings, but you can see how where there's paint, it already starts to blend. Okay, and lastly, I want to work on blending or glazing, because one of the requirements is to let your watercolor dry and then layer over the top of it. This would be another technique to try if you didn't have that extra day to let your paper dry and add the color to it. So blending two colors together. So I'm going to try blue and purple together. So I get some water, some paint, and it's almost like I'm doing my gradient washes, but you have to do it quickly, and you can start adding that purple to it. And the more water you add in the middle, the more it will start to blend together and layer over the top of each other. Okay? And that'll create really cool effects for your skies or your buildings as well. All right, now let's go ahead and get started on yours. I want to see all seven of these techniques. Make sure that you put your name on your paper, because they will be turned in as your medium processing grade.